we have a very interesting session today on animation and digital skills. And for this, we have with us Dr. Abhishek Kumar. So on behalf of the AIM and ATL team, I take this opportunity to welcome Dr. Abhishek Kumar for today's session on animation and digital skills. Dr. Abhishek has a doctorate in computer applications and holds a dual master's degree in animation and visual effects. He is an Apple certified associate, Adobe education trainer, and also certified by Autodesk. He is actively working as the course coordinator of the animations course running on the SWAYAM portal by MHRD. He is also the course developer of the course Graphic Design and Visualization to be aired on the SWAYAM Prabha television channel. He has trained over 90,000 students across the globe. His alumni have worked several national and international movies like Krish, Dhoom, Life of Pi, Avengers series, Iron Man series, Prince of Persia, the Transformers series, Bahubali, to name a few. I hope you all are ready to start this exciting session and have installed the open source softwares Maya and DaVinci for the session. So let's begin. So we are very excited to have you with us today, and without any further delay, I hand over the stage to you.
Thanks a lot, ma'am, and very good evening to everyone. So I think without taking more time, let us start the session. So like hope all you having a little idea about the today's session, but meanwhile, if you're not, okay, no worry, I'm going to demonstrate in detail. So I'm Dr. Abhishek, and today our agenda to go learn about something new creative field over there, which is an emerging field, you can say, into the field of creative visualization and design itself. So today we are not going to learn about only photography. Today we are not only going to learn about the cartoons. Today not only we are going to learn about or what going to watch the enjoying movies and all. So what is about? So this is something totally creative and little interesting also, like ma'am has already stated earlier. So it's about digital visual effects, right? So it's a digital animation and visual effects. So the query is here, maybe you have a little idea about the animation. So animation means common people thinking, okay, so making cartoons and all these are a part of animation. So what is the new visual effect? So this is something integrated of animation and real life CGI integrated clip, the part of VFX. So today we are going to know in detail about the CGI integrated animation and VFX itself. So if you're talking about the VFX specifically, I had kept a lot of images with respect to world's blockbuster movies like Lord of the Rings, Prince of Persia, Pirates of the Caribbean, Titanic, Harry Potter, Jurassic Park, LOR itself. So what are the common things I hear? If you will go in detail and if you check the Wikipedia of these all movies, one thing are common. That common thing is what? This is all are Oscar winner movies, right? So the Oscar winner movie with respect to their quality, with respect to their content, this so specifically if we're talking about the cinema movie, or you can say the computer graphics integrated industry right now, even in India also, lot of movies coming integrated with VFX. Like one of the very good example was the Bahubali, who has changed the scenario of Indian cinema into the different perspective itself, right? So prerequisite of the course, you should be having a little idea about the computer vision, image processing, or computer graphics. If it's available, it's a really very good. If not, no worry about that. I'm going to share with you about from the scratch to like intermediate. So definitely after completions of today, this one short demonstrative sessions, at least you should be having idea about what is exactly digital visual effects and what is exactly animation, and how in future after your schooling or after your college life, you can again make your career into this one field also, because this is an emerging field. And specifically if you're talking about communication design, is everywhere, right? So I'm going to demonstrate you each and everything in detail because we're having a little limited time, so I'm going a little faster. Definitely end of the sessions we're having a specific time for Q&A sessions, so you all are most welcome to get discussed with your respective questions right here. So if we're talking about our reality, this is one of the images which I had to get captured. For example, here you can check out this one. Lady image, somehow the age of this lady is looking like on average 45 to 50 year old. But using the digital computer graphics, we are somehow integrated the things. And here you can get check out the second image. Here you can properly get marked this one area. I'm just changing. So what you can see the difference between both images. Like here we had to get shifted these both images. This both, like here you can check out the photo frames into the bottom. And if you check the difference between the face of the lady, so somehow the age has been get changed over there. So these are some of the really very basic examples of digital graphics itself, right? Where we are able to just manipulate the images to get produce something new results over there, right? Some of the more examples, let us share in the same, like, for example, here you can get check out. These are the images, voting images over there. This is the second image over there. So here you can get check out. This one area had been get extracted and this one area had been get extracted from here, right? And just we had to get merge the both image here. But it's looking like, okay, somehow this entire voting scene, it belongs to this one thing over there, right? So these are something basic foundations of, you can say, the graphic integrated visualizing itself. So these are somehow we are just working into the images and the same kind of concept, integrated concept, we are utilizing to the videos also, right? So how the things would be get applicable today, we are going to learn again. Now here, this is a different example. Like commonly here, you can see this is a photograph, different capture, different place capture. So all these three that has been get blended and merged, and this is the final result over there. So this is the example of image manipulations. This is one of the retouching examples, Iraq War, LA Times, 2003. So here you can get check out. First image is here, second image is here. So just this one, here you can get check out. This one is watching here and here. This one hand is here. This is your gun is little down. So just making the alignment of the both things, the image has been get disconnected. Or you can say the extracted from this one area. And finally, here you can get check out. The image has been get blended and image has been get updated like this one, a final image over here, right? So some of the examples I'm also going to, again, like, for example, if whenever we are working into the big canvas of a screen, at that time, definitely at one time, it's not possible to get capture entire panorama over there. Yeah, definitely right now we're having the N number of digital cameras who are taking capture of photography 108 megapixels resolution and higher than that also. But itself, whenever we are talking about a 4K movie or IMAX edition movie, at that time, we require more pixels. At that time, we require more detail in images. So here you can get check out. These are the images has been get random captured from the same locations over there. And later on, we had a get just manipulated and stitched all the photographs. And here you can get check out after this one little reduced and this one's some more compilations. And here you can get check out. This is the final big full screen image, which has been get manipulated by these all images. And this is the final output. Here you can get check out. This is example of auto stitching over there, right? So whenever you are talking about, these are the some of the basics foundations skill which are you have a little idea how we are working with the image manipulations. Now it's a time to get learned about how in a cinema, how into the movie, how into the visual effects industry we are working and going ahead. So definitely for working any kind of movies, working any kind of project, there should be some pipeline, there should be some of the, you can say, the flow chart over there or the methodology over there. So whenever we are talking about the 3D animation, we having a production pipeline. So here you can just check out one of the flow chart I had to make. So I am quickly just demonstrating the same. So whenever you are working into the 3D animation movie, right, like a movie Up over there, right, like a Madagascar's movie over there. So for such kind of movie, which is completely created into the 3D animation software, the software, like, for example, industry is still working into the Autodesk Maya application, but we having open source applications also, Blender, but still in a Blender, we having a little glitches and not much powerful with comparison to Maya. But yeah, maybe after coming here, Blender is integrating their quality a lot and lot, right? But still, if we talking about the film production house, and if we're talking about a big cinema, right, like Transformer, like Bahubali, like Terminator, right? So these things, whenever we are talking about the same, then at that time we have to just go ahead into complete pipelines over there, right here. So here you can get check out. First is the pre-production. So in a pre-production, first of all, we are analyzing about the concept, right? Concept means what? A story, right? How, what with respect to artwork we are designing, right? Then we are adding some stills over there. when pre-production stage is finished, that means concept sketches, design, script has been written, then it's like time to get work into the 3D model, 3D design over there, right? For example, if you're talking about a movie like a Harry Potter, or if you're talking about the movie like a Spider-Man or Avengers series or Transformers itself, definitely all you believe Transformer character are not real characters over there, but still, if you're watching the movie, that is looking like a real world scenario. If that Transformer would be alive, that would look like that only. Even recently, last week, I had enjoyed the movie King Kong over there. So if you're talking about that gorilla big character over there, Kong character, right? So even that is not also exist into the real world, but itself, when you're watching the movie, that's looking like a real only. Even if you're talking about the Jurassic Park character, right? So in a Jurassic Park, if you're talking about the dinosaurs itself, definitely till date in our generation no one has seen a dinosaur. But if you're talking about the dinosaur, how we graph is going to be created? So after whatever presentations we had given in a films and a movies, so okay, dinosaur means what, a big giant characters over there, some dinosaurs are vegetarian, non-vegetarian, so these are all concepts coming definitely from the scientific books itself. But with respect to the movies, 90% audience are easily able to analyze, okay, if you're talking about the dinosaur or Jurassic Park, okay, that is figure coming over there. So it's a time to you can say the realistic result based computer graphics oriented cinema is going on, right? So when the visuals completed, then it's the time to add the some VFX, then music, then sound, and finally it has been went to the post-production and film stage, and finally that would be go to the cinema theater for launch. So these are the some examples whatever I had demonstrated. Like here, this is an example of pre-production. Somehow this one called the storyboard also. So using the rough concept sketches here, you can get check out, okay, whatever their story, it's easily get understandable, right? This is the visuals of Return of the King, Book 6, Chapter 3, Mount Doom. So these are some of the concept sketches which commonly we draw before going to the live work, right? So storyboard means what? These are somehow whatever you had written into the script, into the textual form, that would be converted into the graphical form. So here easily we can get analyzed about the camera angle. We are able to analyze about the low angle shot, high angle shot, mid angle shot. These are all things we are able to fix and finalize into the storyboard over there, right? When a storyboard is complete, there are two type of production, right? If we're talking about the CGI, live action movie, so in a live action movies, now it's a time to go ahead with the references and research. When a script is finalized, right? When your story is finalized, now you have to analyze. Like for example, if you have to make a movie like a horror movie, and definitely, yeah, in this time, if you're talking about the stars, the heroes, or the star cast, actor or actresses, they are like acting into the multiple way, either a positive role or negative role. But definitely, if you're talking about you have to make a horror movie, and if you want to get cast a Shahid Kapoor type of actor, definitely that not maybe much suitable. For a romantic movie, maybe that may be much suitable. So with respect to your story, with respect to your fund, budget also, it's also important. You can't afford, like definitely all actors having a different kind of budget. So accordingly, we are doing research. Accordingly, we are finalizing what kind of data we can go ahead into the capture shooting the movie. If we're talking about like pre-production stage, so here you can get check out one more thing. This is a real like live capture where you can get check out something. The green color of background has been get fixed over there, right? And this one character just walking into one of the tile level, like you can see the reflective surface over there. But later on, using the computer integrated graphics technology itself, we are able to remove this from the background. Today in a live demonstration, quickly I will demonstrate how you can remove this kind of backgrounds over there from the visuals also. Then that has been get blended with the 3D. Like for 3D assets, we are using the Maya applications commonly into the industry, right? But commonly as an open source, you can use the Blender also, you can use the Maya also, Max softwares also, Cinema 4D, Houdini, lot of applications are there. But commonly, if we're talking about the applications, applications are just tools. If your concept is clear, either you are using any application, end of the day, fundamental are same into all applications. So just have look, this is the real footage and how using the 3D both data has been get blended and output is just something totally changed, right? So I'm just playing the video. So So I had just unmuted the audio because this is a not class specific dedicated for the audio itself, the class for the computer graphics, integrated visual effects and animations only. So here you can just check out, okay, this is one of the sort. I'm just doing one pause here. Like here you can get check out, okay, this one small room only, the entire video has been get captured. Later on we had just removed this one background and just we had added 3D integrated background over there and we had a blended. Now the common question you may have it, like why only in our several movies, like you may have watched a movie breakdown of Bahubali itself, or if you had a watch of like making of other movies over there, then why only green, why not black, or why not some other colors over there? So commonly if you're talking about the computer graphics itself, definitely whatever element visible in front of a screen over there, they are going with three basic color RGB channels over there, red, green, blue channels. So if we're talking about the human body, in our human body commonly red color of tonal ranges are very much, right? So due to red color of tonal range, commonly we are avoiding red color of background whenever we have to extract the matte. So somehow in movies you are able to check the blue color of background, somehow you may able to check the green color of background. Now why he has using a green not blue, because here already blue color has been get used into the real shot. So if they are using blue color of background, computer are not able to by default understand which blue color we don't want or which green color we don't want. So if we're removing this one color from here, the color would be also get removed from here if the both color would be the same, right? So just have look the same. Fine, so hope now you're having a little idea how a digital graphics has been get integrated even in a small advertisements. Also a lot of visual effects, like all the scene has been get created into the 3D applications also. Yeah, definitely it's a time taking process. It's not like that within a day things is going to be complete. Definitely for making such kind of a small commercials itself into the production house, if we're talking about a student project, then definitely if 6 to 7 students working in a team executing such kind of really very beautiful result, it will take minimum 2.5 to 3 months of time for an excellent result, a complete commercial, right? So this is the first example. If we're talking about little more about the visual effects, so first of all we should know about the industry scenario, right? If specific, if we are talking about the animation and VFX market growth rate by geographical region by 2020 to 2025, and you can check out this one, all green area, India and subcontinent here and Australia itself, they having a highest growth rate of animation and VFX market. These are the source has been get extracted by the Mordor intelligence itself. And even in India specifically, if you're talking about during the COVID-19 specifically, a new era of like you can say the movies, new era of animation and VFX has been green up. Even a several big budget movies is also going to be launched into the OTT platforms only, in a Netflix, in a Amazon, in a Disney Hotstar. You may able to watch a several new movies, which is now for that you don't want you if you don't want to go to the cinema theater, even you can enjoy from home also. So such kind of things happening. Specifically if you're talking about Indian film industry, more than 1200 films annually across 20 plus key language India is producing. And definitely if you're talking about newspapers, more than 70,000 plus newspapers on a various language, either online and offline, yeah, mixed blended has been available. And specifically if you're talking about during COVID-19 specifically, with the help of Government of India digital initiative specifically, and users requirement also, this one year if you're talking about the handsets, if you're talking about the tablets, right, 80% exponentially growth has been get up into the market, right? So we can say definitely digitalization is going up and up and up, right? So that was earlier whatever I had said related to the 3D animations movie. But second, now we are talking about the VFX in a detail. Very soon we are going to see the same. So some of the foundation concept you should be clear, because the motto behind this one sessions, at least after completion of this one session, you can get explore the things little more and you came to know about the same more detail into efficient and effective ways. So if you're talking about the VFX pipeline, VFX methodology, so first of all, again, we are going to do the storyboard visualization, then live shooting, then digitalization, then rotoscopy is what, in a short term, if you want to describe about the rotoscopy, for example, somehow we had taken capture the content into the green screen on blue screens over there, but still we are not able to particularly extract the content very smoothly or clear, then at that time, manual masking techniques help us. That manual masking technique called the rotoscopy. Then camera match moving. We having some more example than wire removal, then compositing, 3D assets, matte painting, dynamic effects, then final edit, then output. This is the one of the methodology whenever you are talking about the VFX animation integrated movies over there, right? This is one of the examples which I'm going to share over here, matting and compositing, right? Definitely you may have watched this one movie, Titanic, right? One of the blockbuster movies across the world. So here, these are the raw footage you can get understand. This is the real photographs, green screen. Then later on, this is a different video. This is the 3D sets over there. And this is somehow they had just make a big set over there, right? Big pond there, they had kept one portion of the ship over there and they had get recorded the ship over there and they had integrated that ship with a 3D software. Then somehow they both match the content and somehow final output is coming like this one. So these are the four different footages has been get blended to get execute this one result over there. Definitely if you're talking about the special effects, so two type of effects are going on. One is the special effects where we are manually on a human face, we are integrating, we are adding the detail over there. Second is the CGI integrated makeup where we in a software we are created the replica of the humans over there. Somehow if you go and check out the research itself, right now a lot of research is going into the digital human itself also, right? Using general adversarial network methodology, GAN methodology also over there. So that is a part of digital human. So this is a live where using a special effects and makeup, this one character has been get changed the look and feel. If you're talking about the special effects, somehow definitely if in India, we talked about the movies of Rohit Shetty itself, they are a lively going to be record several footages over there. But definitely whenever you are going to live record each and everything at that time, what's the problem will happen? Maybe some sort is not perfectly get executed, then what will happen? The big loss would be happen, right? So alternatively, now we are talking about the digital visual effects where we are going to create each and everything into the computer. Definitely, it's a little more expensive sometime with comparison to real itself. But if you're talking about the accuracy, we having several add-on methodology where we can meet the accuracy into digital visual effects itself, right? So like I tell you some of the keywords whenever we are discussing about the VFX. So this is a one of example of miniature. So here you can get check out this one, a camera here and a background. It's a looking like a Himalayas background over there, right? And just one character has in between seated over there. And after taking the photograph, it's a looking like the character is seated into the background of Himalayas regions over there. Right, this is again a traditional matte painting methodology. Now matte painting is what, if you're talking about the movie like a Bahubali, definitely very beautiful backgrounds was created over there. If you talk about the movie like Avatar, so in Avatar again the background very beautiful, a natural background, but adding effects was over there. So traditional methodology, we are onto the big canvas, matte painting manually, artists paint the background, and we are using miniature methodology like earlier, which I had shared with you, we are changing the background. But now it's a time to the digitalizations. We are using the Adobe Photoshop applications. We having multiple applications, which we are utilizing specifically if you're talking about the 3D. Matte painting, somehow we are integrating Autodesk Maya, Nuke itself for a 3D matte painting. We having one more dedicated applications. If you're talking about the world best blockbusters like Transformers, Terminator, Industrial Light and Magic Studio, they are the leading studio. They are using Clarity applications for a digital matte painting itself, right? We are using the production methodology, projection techniques. We are created 3D data into 3D application. Then using the projection technique, we are integrated that data into that kind of 3D application known as a Clarity itself. right? So these are the some of the examples. This is a one of the sort of LOR, Lord of the Rings. So here you can get check out, the background is looking like this one, but the real sort, how funny this was, right? So this is like this one character is seated here and manually he was just lifting up and down, and the background we had a change over there, then that's looking like, okay, the character is moving over there. So these are the some of the cheat sheets whenever we are working into the movie. A long time back itself we are doing itself, but now we having a digital tools. So using digital tools, somehow we are integrated the things into much efficient and effective way. And here you can just check out this one, a real for a shoot over there. Later on, using the Autodesk Maya itself, this one background has been get created and both footage has been get merged and into the final movie. Yeah, definitely one of the very interesting movie. Even you can check out the details also. Matrix, one of the revolution into the VFX integrated movies over there. Till date, if you're talking about the Indian cinema itself, right? Even you are comparing the Matrix movie with respect to current day Indian cinema also, still Matrix having a lot of things they had done around 10 plus years back, well, not 10, around 15 to 20, 15 years plus back, they had made a Matrix project over there. Such kind of effects still till date not even going to be applied, or you can say such kind of quality even not has been get produced for Indian cinema. Definitely for international project, several Indians are dedicated their work to get execute the quality. But end of that, definitely if you want to maintain the quality, lot of investment required. Somehow the budget we having with respect to the Hollywood project, in a Bollywood project, we having little less budgets over there. So these are the, some of the limitations. Here you can get check out, these are the image of MoCo camera, motion control camera. So whatever body gestures, movements are going over there. So these are the one of the traditional methodology we are using. This camera, we are capturing the motion capture. Now we having a sensors which we can put into the body, and using that sensors also we are going to capture the motion movement over there. So such things is now available with us, right? This is one of the shot, specifically if you're talking about the movies, somehow in a movie we having a 360 shots where character just jump and entire camera has been just rolled 360 time. So for making such kind of shot, here you can check out this one called the camera rig. So we are just creating 360 camera and using one trigger flash at one shot, all camera click the image. And just we are keeping that all images into the timeline, and when we play over there, it's looking like the entire character has been rotated 360 degrees. So these are the some of the methodology which we are using into the 360 shots over there, right? This one, the methodology, like right now we are working with some of the project. So using like a texture mapping and photogrammetric, we are now working with a replica of the real world model. For example, if we are talking about maybe if I'm talking about any monument which right now not into the original stage over there, but still if we want to go into the details over there, so we can, yeah. Some voice was coming. Okay, coming back to the session. Okay, so if you're talking about, so these are the methodology, photogrammetric. So these all things somehow CGI integrated. So again, here you can get check out the dummy model has been get created into the Autodesk Maya application. Then later on, we had done the using projection techniques, we had integrated the same. Right. So this is a somehow the this one a 3D image has been get replicated into the real world environment. Right. So I'm just moving next. So this is again camera projections example where we are keeping matte painting in between and somehow 3D background or sometime real set also we are keeping, and this is a somehow final result is coming over there, right? Now if you're talking about the industry scenario, right? So a lot of projects coming, a lot of movies coming, and each and every movie having a lot of VFX added over there. Specifically, if you're talking about one of the channel Life OK, specifically into the you can say the daily television serials over there. So one of the serial Devo Ke Diyo Mahadev, that was changed the entire scenario of presenting the god goddess in a science fiction's way. A power is looking like a power and effects has been get applied over there. So after that project Devo Ke Diyo Mahadev on Life OK, later on you can check out several like television serials has been also starting integrated the VFX into the television serials also. Right. So this is one of the industry showcase in a VFX, how we are adding several things in a 3D integrated movie. Somehow whenever you are watching a movie, you may not able to recognize what kind of cheat sheet we had done over there. Just have looked the same. So this one, a project Bhaag Milka Bhaag, right? So here a lot of VFX itself has been get used. So you can just check out this one character just running where, and the image has been get changed. And now it's looking like, okay, character is running on train itself. So entire this one data has been get created into the 3D application itself. And these are the real photographs. Again, you can get check out, a huge crowd is here. So definitely you can think a such huge crowd, you can't record the movie because such crowd would be available over there. Definitely someone would be a big fan of the artist over there, big fan of the actor. Somehow either a lot of security would be over there. Still, they will disturb during the time of shooting. So such kind of precautions, what we are doing, we are creating a digital replica over there. So we are capturing the video in different place and later on we are implementing the same. So here you can get check out how the things have been get executed. See, so here you can get check out this one crowd has been get replicated here to here to here, but this is a camera from the long shot view. So somehow we are not able to recognize same character has been randomly get just shifted and pasted over there, right? So this is a one of the example. This one here you can check out the replica, nothing was over there. The entire this one bridge has been get created into the 3D implemented. So over there the character then pasted over there, right? So these are the one of the examples of domestic industry showcase, right? Even right now, if you're talking about the industry scenario of VFX, a lot of project is coming, even into the original cinema also, like Shraya, Adi Purush, and Bhagmati, if I'm not wrong, the name of this one movie, right? So these all movies are having also a lot of VFX has been get integrated itself, right? Maximum backgrounds has been get created into the 3D itself, right? Definitely in Hollywood, these are the blockbuster projects, specifically the Marvel series, recently Godzilla and Kong, Spider-Man series, Transformer. So the entire character has been get developed and designed into the Autodesk Maya itself. The Transformer, this 3D character, later on they had implemented this one character integrated with the CGI, and somehow the result you had a scene, and somehow now we do believe Transformers. Okay, that means a transformable characters over there, right? So these are the some of the project, how international industry work over there. So these are the some of the work here. This is also not real. The entire things you can see over there has been get created into the 3D applications only. So these are the some of the works where a lot of computer graphics integrated work is applied over there, right? So I'm skipping little fast. So here, yeah, this is a, one of the very beautiful example of a dynamic simulation, right? So this is a simulation for creating such kind of effects. We are using real flow applications over there integrated with Autodesk Maya, right? So here you can get check out the entire things has been get created into the application software only. Nothing was real over there. But commonly when you watch the movie, it's a looking like, oh, it's 100% real over there. Right, so this entire fire shot has been created in 3D applications itself only. Yeah, definitely. These are very much time taken and in detail we are working. But yeah, end of the day, definitely if you want to go in detail and if you want to just create a quality content, you need to give the time also. So these are the one of the examples. Now, if we're talking about the VFX, definitely one of the last year loss of Indian cinema, Sushant Singh Rajput. There was one very good project, one very good movie. Definitely, movie has not earned a lot, but in this one movie, lot of VFX has been get integrated. So the Prime Focus Studio has lead the entire projects over there. So here you can get check out. This entire shot has been done into the 3D application itself. So nothing was real over there. So like here we can say it's not like that Indian cinema. We are not maintaining the quality over there. Somehow you can see the entire scene has been get created into 3D. Nothing is real over there, right? So they're using the matte painting techniques. Earlier, some of the examples which I had to share with you. So these are the real world like applications which you can get check out into the movie happening. So definitely camera has been went with a very close. So just you can imagine how such close, if any chopper can be go. So the entire chopper has been get created into 3D only. This one fish has been also again 3D itself over there. So the project name was a Rapta itself. So a lot of VFX has been get applied into this one movie. So interesting, like entire simulation shot you can get check out over here. So these all fish are not real, but definitely if you had watched the movie, you may thought, okay, the entire shot has been get captured into the any big aquarium only, right? But just you imagine in aquarium, if such kind of shoot happening, then how this one eye would be 100% completely open over there. If the catar would be breathe, definitely somehow breathing bubbles would be go from there. Here you can get check out this one had get captured into different place, and then it has been get more over there. So such kind of effects, such kind of detailed work, even we are doing into the Bollywood, the movies itself over there. But common people, you are not able to recognize what kind of effects, what kind of like a cheat sheets we had done into such kind of projects. So these are some of the work. Yeah, definitely if you're talking about the Hollywood project, more budget involved over there. So definitely detail quality, you can see the more detailed effects simulations is applied over there. Even slowly, slowly, India is also going up and up and up with respect to the quality, like preservance in industry with respect to their Bollywood project. Or you can even get check out from last 2 to 3 years, specifically if you're talking about the Telugu cinema or if you're talking about the South Indian cinema, even they are working a lot into the VFX. And now you can get check out specifically if you're talking about the South Indian cinema. Now people are eagerly more waiting to get to watch the movie into the converted into their native language was over there, and they are enjoying more. So maybe definitely in a future time we can say several like you can say the dubbed versions of movie, even the complete movie which earlier was created into the South Indian cinema, they had just changed the character. Each and every shot was the same. Again, they're creating into the Bollywood itself, and again Bollywood's making a lot of monies over there itself. So such kind of things is happening, such kind of details right now definitely into the Indian cinema also we are applied. Like here you can check out a multiple breakdown. So how the characters have been getting multiply into detail. So crowd we are generating over there, right? So this is a project of this one movie itself. And if I'm talking about the Hollywood, definitely in Hollywood somehow we are not thinking about the budget. We are not thinking about somehow the project is going delay itself. But end of the day, specifically the producers from the Hollywood and the director from the Hollywood, they are never compromised with the result. Even the minute details are not properly going to be follow up, they are again going to complete the details into more detail, more accurate result they are required over there. Like here you can get check out the big set has been get entire scene has been get captured. Then later on the dynamic simulation has been a really very beautifully blended over there, and it's looking like a complete deconstructed shot has been get shot into some open place over here, right? So this is the some of the examples where you can get check out how minute details also whenever we are talking about the Hollywood projects we are keeping over there, right? That's why definitely if you're talking about these projects, end of the day they're taking a lot of times over there, lot of budget, lot of funds over there. But end of the day after completion, definitely eagerly youths are waiting to watch this kind of project, this kind of movies over there. So now definitely after today class, you may having an idea how digital computer graphics are capturing the entire cinema, and definitely whatever things right now you are thinking, like definitely in an Atal Innovations mission itself, we are trying to just motivate, we are trying to nourish our youth into a different manner. Whatever you are visualizing using the 3D integrated computer graphics, you can create that thing into the real world existence also, right dear? So these are some of the examples. As of now, some of the emergence has been also get integrated now, like if you're talking about the 3D like softwares over there, these are not only limited to the movies, these are not only limited to the cinema itself. Right now in a 3D visualization technology, definitely if you're talking about your dream home, now before completion of entire real dream home, people want to see how my home would be look like. So using the 3D visualization technology, using the architecture visualization methodology, before completion of entire apartment, we are able to visualize how my dream home will look like. If any kind of modification required, immediately we can get implemented into the 3D application, and if we satisfied accordingly, then only we are going to be upgrade the things. So these are like rapidly applicable into the interior design itself. So earlier they are making entire scene into the 3D, if client approved, then only they are going into the real world upgradations over there. Emerging technology, augmented reality and virtual reality, if you're talking about the AR and VR in short term also. So using the AR and VR, definitely we can feel of a CG world using the Google headset or using the HTC Vive's headsets itself. We can feel that CG world, we are interacting with them also for interactions. Now we can go ahead with a Google HoloLens. So that is an example of XR, extended reality, or you can say the mixed reality, where we can little interact with the CG objects, which is not really existing, but using that headset, we feel we are interacting with that kind of project. 3D printing again. So using the 3D printing here, you can check out, this is the one example of 3D printing. So entire model has been get created into the 3D application. Then using the 3D printed, we have just put it the command. So entire model has been get printed and the model in our hand. Again, 3D entertainment apps right now, definitely if you're talking about the education, definitely if you talk about our time, we had a get learn into the whiteboard and a blackboard. So but right now during this digital era, even our teachers and professors are also teaching using the some of the visual contents over there, using the animation graphic teacher training the student, even in a kindergarten schools also, using the, you can say, the animated video, they are teaching A, B, C, D alphabets and the numerical digits, and like how to analyze and how to get acquire what content objects are over there. So in a 3D entertainment apps also, we are utilizing 3D animations a lot, right? So these are some of the 3D printing example you can see, prototyping, everyday use arts. Right, so augmented reality examples. So whatever, using the cell phone, when you keeping the cell phone scan code over there, so you can feel the model has been get converted to the 3D itself, right? So these are the example of 3D. Again, more detail of augmented reality. So here you can get check out, okay, there is a pizza corner, there is the Twitter, National Museum, free Wi-Fi available over there, bank check-in is over there. So these are the integrated some of the works which right now currently going into the industry using 3D integrated computer graphics itself, right? 3D entertainment apps, like using the games also, right now several applications are available into the Android Play Store itself, where we can get play the games to get learn something new, right? So gamification in education is also applied. So cognitive science, or you can say easily our kids can understand how the things have been going up, right? So these are the some of the things. Specifically, if you're talking about the career opportunity, if any things we are going to learn, which are the some of the key like area as a composer, camera tracker, mass move artist, depth artist, VFX journalist, editor, these are the some of the key result area or the career opportunity if you are going to learn these things in more detail, right? Definitely such kind of course, if you want to learn, it's a take around 2 to 3 years of time, then only you may able to create something in a more detail. These are some of the companies like Red Chili's, Prime Focus, Famous Studio, Tata Alexa, MPC, they are working like you can see as a leader into the VFX, or you can say the live action integrated movie also, fine. if you want to get learn about the animation in more detail, yeah, definitely under the Government of India program, Swayam, you can get learn the complete 3D animation course at free of cost into the Swayam platform. Just you have to type the swayam.gov.in in. So next semester, again, enrollment would be get a start. So this one course has been get designed for the unwise learner who having no any idea about 3D itself, but they have idea about how to operate the computer, how to play with the mouse, how to play with the keyboard. Then he or she can start the course also, right here. So now it's a time to have some practical. Meanwhile, if you're having any query, any question with respect to this entire presentation, you can feel free to ask with me. Then we will go with the software and whatever things as of now I had demonstrated with you. With respect to that, some of the real life like demonstrations I'm going to give with you practically. So anyone having any query, any questions, feel free to ask with me. Or we're having officially like a time dedicated for Q&A at end also. So what I'm doing, like we having next 15 minutes with me. So immediately I'm switching to the software application. So you may having little idea how the things we can get work into 3D applications also, right? So just like I had shared several projects where such kind of background, futuristic background was over there. So just I had a type castle into the Google, right? So these are some of the castle images I just got here. So I'm quickly going to demonstrate, for example, if you have to create such kind of things over in a 3D application, how 3D applications work, right? So for that here, just I'm launching the Maya application. Stop sharing. I'm sharing my complete screen, so that would be easily to understand. One minute. Yeah, fine. So now hope my entire screen is visible with everyone. So here just I had typed the castle into the Google. So a lot of castle images I am able to see here. Just let us go with anyone, like, okay, let us click on this one, right? So whenever we are working into the 3D application, just first of all, we need to understand the foundation structure, foundation layout of the object. So if we are going to break down this one structure, this is looking like a cylinder, then box shape, again, box shapes over there, in between box shapes, again, cylindrical shape. So just I'm going to share how in a 3D application things working. So this is the interface of Autodesk Maya, and my screen is available here. So whenever you are working into the any 3D applications, you're having a four view, right? So commonly this four view divided into two parts, one into the perspective view and second is the orthographic view, right? Orthographic view means what? Side view, left view, right view, perspective view, where you can get analyze what the project is coming, right? So again, I'm swapping to the castle. So here we can get checkout. Okay, two cylinders are here, in between boxes over here. So we having some standard primitives, a standard model available into the 3D application. So for here, I'm going to just create this one cylinder from top view, right? So cylinder has been get drawn. You can hit the Alt button to get navigate, Alt and left mouse button, LMB. You can rotate it. And for zoom in, zoom out, what you can do, you can hit the Alt button and RMB, right mouse button, to get zoom in, zoom out. So this is one of the basic structure which I had created here. And you can get checkout in between some of the box shapes over there. So first of all, I'm creating the outer area. So this one cylinder has been get created. We having some of the tools here, like select tool, move tool, rotate tool, right? So just I am going with the select tool over here. So this one object I had created, and for duplicate the object, you can hit the Control D from the keyboard, right? So the object has been just get duplicated, right? So now object is here. Now I'm going to create a box shape over there in between, right? You can simply draw the box over here. Now again, check the reference images. Okay. So this one is little back. So from the top view, we can put little back. And for a scale the object, you be having the selection, move, scale, right? So we can scale it a little. Fine, dear. So now you can get checkout the result. Just I'm layouting little back, little more scale it. Right? Again, I want to create the box. So again, I'm creating some more box over here. Right? So these are the 3D application. So here you can now just check out, okay, somehow our basic shapes are coming here, right? So here again, if you want to see, okay, in top, some of the details are over here. So for that, definitely you need to go ahead a little more detail. So for that, what I'm doing here, I'm just zoom in the object over here, right? And here what I'm doing, for that we need some edge loop need to be added over here. So for that I'm going to the edit mesh, and here I'm going to add some of the edge loop tool. So we having insert edge loop tool, so I'm adding some of the details here, right? And what I'm doing, I'm going to the top view again. You can right click and you can change to the case mode, and manually using the shift button you can select the object. Definitely as a fresher it may take little time, but meanwhile you having a little clear concept idea how the things are working. As I told you earlier also, if you want to get learned about the same things in detail, then definitely in a Government of India we had earlier created one of the course dedicated for the animation aspirants only. You can go ahead. So now this one shape has been get converted like this. Now manually I'm right clicking here and switching to the face, right? So I'm selecting face. In between one face I'm leaving, I'm not selecting all the faces, right? Now we have in one of the tools here, so that tool called the extrude, right? So this one extrude I'm using, and again move tool, and we can lift up, right? Send to the object mode. Now see the detail is coming over there, right? So when this one job done, the same replica if we want into this one side, just delete this one, select and delete, select the object and Control D for the duplicate. So again I had a duplicated this one, right? So these are the some of the methodology which you can use to create the basic primitives, right? Even if you want to create a table or chair, immediately you can draw. For example, again I'm creating one of the box, this one box for tabletop, right? And I'm moving little up this one. Now I'm again creating a box space like a leg, you can see table. Now this is a table leg shape here. Again, like if we want to duplicate, this is more thicker. So again, just scale it using R button, right? So again, I want to just copy, select it and Control D for duplicate. So this one data has been get copied here, right? So in between anything you want, just you can again duplicate it, Control D. And you can scale a little, R and scale, right? So using these things, you can create a standard object. So this one table has been getting created, right? So you can just do little practice into application. Either you are using the Autodesk Maya application or Blender application. Both applications, same methodology would be get work. For Maya, just you have to go to the Autodesk.com website or simply in a Google type the Maya student version. So Maya Autodesk is available with all of the students. You can just upload your university, school, ID card over there into respective website for 1 year. The complete software would available with you at a free of cost. You're not required to pay single penny for that, right? So this is a one of the examples how 3D environment things are working. Now I'm switching to the second application, DaVinci Resolve. So for some of the green screen methodology, which I had shared with you. So in a green screen, how the things is working over there. So just for a moment, the application is going to be a start. So specifically, if you're talking about the industry, commonly Adobe After Effects, Nuke application, these are the industry-oriented application we are using for compositing, rotoscopy, motion graphics and all. But because you should be having also access about the software, so I'm just giving you the demonstration into the DaVinci Resolve. This is an open source application. You can go to the DaVinci Resolve website. You can download the entire software. Just you can install. As a student, if you are using this one thing, you have to not pay anything. But definitely for commercial purpose, if anyone is using this one software, they have to pay something, right? So the interface is coming very soon. Just I'm minimizing this one. Right, so this is the interface of DaVinci Resolve. So I'm hitting into the new project first, right? So when you hit into the new project, just put the name EIM, Atal Innovation Mission _ D3, right? I'm hitting into the create button. So when you hit into the create button, now this is the interface of the applications over here, right? So here you can get check out this one, no media clips into the pool. So I'm just going to the file, right? And here you can use the import media, right? Or in a shortcut, you can use the Control I also. So some of the footage I had just get collected here, right? One of my education lecture also just I had recorded. Here you can just check out Right. But yeah, I'm going to use some additional footage also. So here I'm going to demonstrate how background you are going to change. Right. So for that, just I'm using one of the footage here. So this is one of the shot file and import media. Right. So I'm using the footage from here. This is the some of the footages which I had kept into the backup. So when you will be import this one, they are asking change the project frame rate. Okay, let us change it. So we having some of the footage here, like I'm double clicking here. Right. So here you can just play the button. You can see this is the background VG plate over here, right? And here I'm doing double click here. I'm hitting play here. You can get checkout. This is both actors and actresses. See, just seated into the inside one of the, like you can check out car only, car is even not moving. Like here you can just check out, this is one of the camera shot here, where camera is freezed over there. These are some of the background which I had collected over here, right? So now today we are going to demonstrate how we can blend these all things over there, right? So just I'm what doing, first of all, I'm selecting this one shot and right click here, and you can use the create new timeline using the selected clip. So when you will use this one thing, just hit into the create option. Now you can see the entire data is available in a timeline now with us, right? Wait for a while, it will take little time to get adjust, right? So when you hit the play button, now data with us. Okay, now what I required here, now I require this one video footage here. So I'm just dragging this one. You have to use the left mouse button and drag here. So now this one footage on top, right? Now hit the play button. Now what we required, like I had a shared earlier several movie like how international projects or the national projects is working, so how we can change the background over there. So for that, here I am using the fusion options here. In a fusion options, we having effect. Wait for a while, it will take little time. So now we having effect library, right, dear? So in effect library, we having options here. You can just scroll down using the mouse scroll button. You can use the chroma key and ultra key, right? So let us start with the chroma key. When you will use the chroma key, now you have to simply drag the mouse into the color which you don't want, right? But what happening, this is not giving you the best result. So I'm giving you the option, using what options you can take the best result. So here you have to use the ultra gear, right? So when you use the ultra gear over there, this one giving a node based options over here. Now you can go to the side options inspector or the property. Here we having the background color. So I'm just clicking into the eyedropper, just left mouse button, click and drag into the color. So like here I had chosen the blue color. So now here you can see background is blank over there, texture is coming over there. Now again hit into the edit option. So when you hit into the edit option, wait for a while. Now here you can see what happened here, output. Now how it's looking like, it's looking a lucky character is somehow belong here, right? Again, I'm giving you some more example. For example, I'm trying to import my own footage over here. File and import and media. So same thing, for example, I'm keeping my footage over here. It's a very long 30 hour of shot over here, right? And I'm just keeping a background, this one image over here. And what I'm doing here, just I'm selecting and do apply the same thing over there using the fusion, right? Wait for a while, right? And now we have to apply what effect do you hear? That effect known as the ultra gear, right? So where is the ultra gear? Right? And now here I had again click into the green color, right? So now see what is the edit result is coming over here. Now see, now it's looking like where I'm standing in front of some of the horrible background over there. Fine. The footage file size is very happy, 4K, that's why it's a little going slow. Fine. So hope now your fundamental concept is clear, how exactly VFX and a 3D industry is working. So these are something which I'm going to demonstrate with all of you. So when, if your job is done, simply what you can do, how to export the data. You have to just click into the deliver button, and after hitting into the deliver button, you have to choose the location where you want to save the file. You can define the file. Maybe I'm going to save the file into the desktop. After that, you have to hit into the add to render queue. After adding hit to the render queue, hit into the button render all. Your job is done. So this is the methodology, how the things is going to be executed, right? So now file with you onto the desktop, right? Here you can check out the file with us. Some file is missing, so this is giving little jerk over there, right? But now hope you having a little idea how the things is going to be created into the VFX and CGI integrated world. Now definitely if you having any query, any question, please let me know, right? And for further, like I tell you earlier also, if you want to know more about the animation and digital visual effects, definitely you can opt one of the course that initiated by Government of India, swayam.gov.in. You can get learn the same things, either it's related to animation, you want to learn the C programming, you want to learn the Python, lot of things are freely available over there. Fine dear, so it's a time of Q&A, and thanks a lot. Thanks Atal Innovation Mission team to giving me opportunity to share some of my input to my younger brothers, you can say, or the youth for the future of our country. Thanks a lot. Thanks AIM team.
Thank you so much, Abhishek, for sharing a wonderful presentation with all of us. And we thank you for your time to give us an introduction about what animation is and how we can actually leverage this particular technology. With that, it's time for our next session. And for that, we'll just take a 1 minute break and we'll get back to you at the earliest. Please note that whatever content which has been shared in this particular presentation is for education purposes only. Thank you so much, and we'll reconnect with you in another 1 minute.
Thanks a lot. Have a good day.